We're back here at Kapiolani Community College, and we're learning all about their culinary arts program. So we have program director Grant, as well as chef instructor Alan, here with all the details. Aloha, you guys.
Aloha. Aloha.
And as you can see, we also have some delicious food in front of us as well. I'm so excited to be getting into this. But before we talk about the program, who cooked this food?
We had our students and students from Fukuoka. They're coming here on an exchange program, and they cook the food today.
Awesome. So this was all of the students.
Yes.
So that must be so cool, seeing the students learning so well and coming up with these beautiful dishes.
Absolutely. So, you know, when we did this, we wanted to also do a Hawaiian kind of cultural experience for them, not just any food. So this is their first day here, and today they're doing Hawaiian
food. This is their first day, and this is what they get?
This is what they should be doing on the first day.
Oh my gosh, they're getting an awesome luau. Okay, I'm about to eat this really fresh poi, but before I do, let's talk a bit about, you know, Gooch was saying earlier, as we were talking about and making this poi, he was saying that, you know, a class like this didn't exist when he came here. So how has the culinary program changed to keep up with the times?
So we're trying right now something new. It's basically trying to take our studies outside of the classroom.
Mm-hmm.
So we're doing different things. This is one of them. But we also have students go to coffee farms. We've had one to go to coffee farm. We're gonna have somebody to come in to do pig butchery and all different kinds of things that we have on the board right now, on the plate. And we're taking it outside of the classroom.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of where we're heading it. We know we're still doing our traditional fundamental skills here. You know, we're still doing what we did well for the last 20 or 30 years, but we're adding on more things so the students can get more excited about it. You know, as culinarians, as chefs, we love to travel. We love to do things outside of, you know, and have experts come and teach us. So that's kind of what we're trying to do for our students.
I love that. And it sounds like, too, I mean, when you're getting out there and seeing, you know, where all these fresh ingredients come from, I feel like that will also enhance the cooking, not just keep them captivated.
Absolutely. We travel to all different kinds of places. Well, we're about to travel to the tilapia, Kunia Farms, where they do aquaponic, where they do tilapia, and they do lettuces. So, you know, we take them to watercress farm, we take them to all different kinds of places so they can learn where the food comes from, you know, so they know where the food comes from, and then they can appreciate the food that they're about to put on the plate.
I love that. And Chef is talking a lot about traveling. Let's talk about the program and the program that we have going on right now. What do you guys have going with the travel abroad?
Yeah, it's pretty unique. You know, one of the things we really wanted to emphasize is the importance of the culinary industry being very global. So for us to be able to have the support, whether it comes from our faculty, our staff, our students, and also our donors, that really helped certain things possible. So we have Fukuoka here today. Their governmental prefecture has set up a program where we do an exchange. So students are here for a week, and then we send our students over there for a week. And, you know, food translates across all languages. And Chef Noguchi kind of mentioned about that as well. So this is a perfect opportunity for people to really engross themselves in other cultures through the lens of that place. And in the near future, we're also looking at potentially traveling to Barcelona, Spain.
Whoa, that's amazing. So, I mean, people already have, though, gone to Japan. What's been the feedback from the students?
You know, I think that's the big thing. You know, we could actually teach a class about Japanese cuisine within the four walls.
Mm-hmm.
And they'll learn about it. They'll, you know, begin to understand some of the nuances. But being able to go there and experience the actual culture there that ties in with the foods, for them, it's, you know, something that they may never get an opportunity to do in that particular way, you know, engross, you know, working with the farmers, working with the chefs there in those countries. So for us, what we hear back from the students is that they love it. And so this is something we're really trying to put forward and make it a hallmark of what we do here at Kapiolani Community College.
I love that. And what does it entail? Who gets to go?
Yeah, so that's a great question. So we have an application process that we utilize because a lot of these programs are in such high demand in terms of students wanting to participate. So we kind of vet them through that process. But the goal is to have every student be able to participate, whether it's going to be to another country or maybe it might be to the Big Island.
Mm-hmm.
There's so much things we can learn from stepping outside of the four walls of our classroom. So again, that's ultimately our goal, that every single student will have that opportunity to do this travel abroad. abroad experience for them to learn more about culinary.
Wonderful. And it's something that, as a chef instructor, you suggest as well?
Oh, absolutely. You know, it's priceless for students or for faculty or chefs to travel or to just be with the experts in their field, right? We definitely going to learn from the best, and it becomes, you know, part of our knowledge, part of our bank of knowledge. So it's definitely something the students and faculty and staff could definitely want to do.
Definitely. I mean, I want to do it. It sounds so amazing. So for those who want to sign up, you know, maybe want to learn more about the culinary arts program here, where do we go for more info or to enroll?
Yeah, so we have our kapiolani.hawaii.edu. So you can get onto the webpage and look for culinary, and we have our page there, and you can see all of our classes that are available. We have contacts with our counselor as well, Laurie Maihara, so they can contact her as well, and you can always contact me as well. I mean, we love, you know, people always think about what we do here and try to promote the college. I think what we try to do is promote culinary across the board, across the entire state, because every one of our community colleges does such an excellent job. Mm-hmm. So for us to be able to meet the students' needs wherever they're at, I think that's the situation we want to create. So it's a win-win for the students coming into any one of our University of Hawaii CC system programs.
I love that. Okay, well, we'll have all of your info and the website on our website at kh12.com, so you can find out more information if you're interested. But you guys, I've already dug into it. I have lau lau, I have poke, I have fresh poi, lomi salmon, chicken long rice, ulu rice. I've dug into most of this, but I know you guys are probably starving watching me. So students, great job. This is so good. I'll send it back to the studio though so I can dig into my long rice now. Thanks so much, guys.
Thank you.
Lalo.
Let's also not only give it up for the students of Kapiolani Community College, but that view.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go.
That's my favorite view.
That's me eating the money shot.
Delicious. And so neat. I mean, these are students from Japan.
Right.
Half of them barely spoke any English. They were all so sweet, all wanted to take pictures. Right. They were so excited about the whole process. But they all cooked a complete Hawaiian luau meal.
Yeah.
How cool is that?
Well, it just goes to show, you know, the power of cooking, how it really is universal. Mm-hmm. And this goes back also to what we were saying in the first segment a couple minutes ago, how this program, not just at Kapiolani Community College, is teaching locals how to embrace the Hawaiian culture, but teaching, you know, Japan visitors as well, you know, a thing or two about Hawaiian culture, which we love.
Love that, yeah. And if you want more information, again, we'll have it all online, but you can enroll for their upcoming semester. So make sure you check it out if your interest is piqued.
That's right.